Hello everyone. So in today's lecture we are going to discuss about the road patterns. So during the planning of city or area, roads are designed in such a way that it fulfills the need of people using it and provide the necessary comfort. That is, it reduces the time and distance between the origin and destination, and it increases the response time for the emergency vehicles and manage traffic and reduce accidental hotspots. So broadly speaking, we have six type of road patterns. The first is rectangular or block pattern. The second is radial or star and block pattern. The third is radial or star and circular pattern. Then we have radial or star and grid pattern, after which comes hexagonal pattern and minimum travel pattern. So in rectangular pattern, what happens is that the whole city is divided into number of rectangular blocks, and the advantage of having such kind of road network is that the first of all is the construction and maintenance of this type of road network is very easy, but this comes with certain limitation. So what happens is that you can see a lot of intersection points are formed in this type of road network. So we have traffic that is coming from this direction, traffic coming from this direction, traffic coming from this direction, and likewise traffic coming from this direction for this intersection point. Likewise, the same can be seen in this intersection point here, 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 and likewise. So we can see that the probability of a collision between two vehicles is quite high in such kind of road network. So this is kind of a limitation of this type of road pattern, and therefore this type of road pattern should be used for low traffic volume areas. Okay, in small cities and cities having low traffic volume, in that areas the rectangular pattern proved to be very successful. And apart from that, we have to make sure that proper traffic management system is available, that is at the proper location we have traffic signs, traffic location or traffic signal should be at the proper place, so as to warn the driver that there is an intersection point ahead of the road. And in India, Chandigarh has the rectangular road pattern, and the whole city, as we can see, is divided into number of rectangular blocks, and we have road network that is running across the city. Okay. After this, we have radial or star and block pattern, and in this pattern, the entire area is divided into number of road radiating from a business in an outward direction. So basically, what happens is we have a central business area, and from that central business area, we have radial road network that are emerging from it. So these major roads are focused toward the central business area, and in between these radial roads we have built up area, that is houses, colonies, small shops, all these things are situated in between these major radial roads. The advantage of having such kind of road pattern is that it reduces the level of congestion. So we know, if we know that we have a central business area and the majority of the traffic is going to travel into this business area, so it's a good decision to make major roads, the roads having a sufficiently good width, to focus toward these central business area, so as the congestion in between the built up area, the congestion between the local street is avoided. And in case one road network is facing congestion or has been closed due to traffic jam, so the commuter can take another road network at any point of time. The limitation of this road network is that this type of road network is efficient when we have a central business area located in a city. If we do not have a central business area, then the usefulness of this kind of road pattern seems to be diminished. After this, we have star and circular pattern, and this type of road network is quite similar to the previous one in ways that this is again focused toward a central business area. It has a radial road network emerging from it, and the difference from the previous type of road network is that these major radial road network are interconnected by the concentric circular road network, and then we have built up area in between these concentric circular road network, which are again interconnected with the help of local streets. Now, the advantage of having this type of road network is that, first of all, unlike previous road network, if one radial road is closed because of maintenance or because of congestion, then the commuter does not have to follow a different path or doesn't have to move from the built up area from the local streets to reach the other major radial road. Concentric circular road patterns are available where the commuter move from one road network to another in a very easy way. Another advantage of this type of road network is that having a concentric circular road network act as a big roundabout, and thus the possibility of accidents are avoided by the availability of such big roundabouts. The limitation of this type of road network is that first of all, allowing the center line of this large circular concentric road network is a job of a precise execution of work. So we need a very precise work execution to join the center line of this concentric road network. The second thing is that since the traffic can be managed by itself, so it is very important that the traffic markings, traffic signs, and other pavement markings are put at their proper place. So this type of road network is available in Connaught Place. So we have a central business area, and from that business area we have radial roads emerging from it, and these roads are connected through a network of circular concentric roads, and in between this we have a built up area that are again connected by the local streets. Next we have star and grid pattern, and the similarity between star and grid pattern is again that this network is also focused toward a central business area, and it has network of radial roads coming out of it, and the difference between this star and grid pattern and the previous one is that instead of circular road pattern, the major radial roads are connected by the straight road network forming a web like structure. So the advantage of having this type of straight road network is that the distance that need to be covered from point A to point B is shorter compared to the previous one, and the second thing is that having a straight road network help us to efficiently use the land area. However, we can again see that having straight road network leads to sharp turns. Sharp turns are created, and because of which the probability of accidents in these sharp turns and intersection is quite high. So there is a need that a proper sign, signals and pavement markings are installed along these intersection points. Such kind of road network is situated in Delhi, and we have a central business area from which the major roads are emerging in a radial direction, and these are connected by a straight road network forming a web like structure. After this we have hexagonal road pattern, and basically here what happens is that colonies are formed, and in the form of hexagonal figures, and the corners of these colony forms the road. The corners of these form the road network. The drawback of this is again that a lot of intersection points are formed, and does require a proper traffic management system. So this is again an example of hexagonal road pattern. Then at the end we have a minimum travel pattern, and here the road networks are basically formed by the shortest route principle, that is the shortest route between the origin and destination points forms the desired road network. So we can say that basically more than a planned format, this type of road network, that is the minimum travel pattern, is a self-evolving road pattern and basically is formed as the city grows, and the most frequent used path to reach from one point to another forms the road network, and thus we have minimum travel pattern available to us. The advantage is in the name of this road pattern, that having such a interconnected road network basically help us to reach from origin to destination in a very shortest time. And the limitation is that there is huge traffic congestion taking place at the joints, and intersection can be a challenging scenario for the older drivers. And so any pattern that has a lot of interconnected road network can come under this type of road pattern, and the only thing that matters in this type of road pattern is that we must reach from point A to point B in the shortest amount of time. So this was all about the road pattern. I hope the lecture was up to your expectation, and if so, like the channel and consider subscribing to it. Press the bell icon to get to know about our the recent post. So that is all for the day. Thank you and have a nice day.